Good morning. We are going to analyze this event.
Flippin' physics.
I thought we already analyzed this.
Yeah.
It was explosion problem demonstration or something like that. That is true. However, this time we are going to look at the demonstration from this perspective.
Ah.
Right.
Bo, please read, and Bobby, please translate the problem.
A 66.0 gram ball is launched from a stationary nerdapult on wheels. The total mass of the nerdapult on wheels is 1,791 grams. If the ball moves with a velocity of -351i plus 179j centimeters per second right after launching, what is the velocity of the nerdapult right after the ball is launched?
The mass of the ball is 66.0 grams. The mass of the nerdapult is 1,791 grams. The initial velocity of both the ball and the nerdapult is zero. The velocity of the ball final equals -351i plus 179j centimeters per second. And the final velocity of the nerdapult equals ?
Thank you, Bo and Bobby. Billy, please solve the problem.
Absolutely. Because all forces are internal to the nerdapult on wheels and ball system, the net force acting on the system is zero.
Hold up, Billy. The force normal acts up, and the force of gravity acts down on these objects. So are all the forces really internal to the system?
Oh, good point, Bo. What I mean to say is that all the forces in the XY plane are internal to the system. The force the nerdapult applies on the ball is equal and opposite to the force the ball applies to the nerdapult. So the momentum of the system in the XY plane is conserved.
Yeah, right. That makes sense.
Okay, and because net force equals the derivative of momentum as a function of time, where both force and momentum are vectors, the linear momentum of the nerdapult on wheels and ball system is conserved. That means the sum of the initial momenta equals the sum of the final momenta. The initial momentum of the system equals zero because the system is at rest before the ball is launched. The final momentum of the system is the summation of the final momentum of the ball and the final momentum of the nerdapult. Solve for the final momentum of the nerdapult, substitute mass times velocity in for both momenta, and divide by the mass of the nerdapult to solve for the final velocity of the nerdapult. We can plug in our numbers to get 12.93467i minus 6.59631j, or, well, 12.9i minus 6.60j centimeters per second with three sig figs.
Very nice, Billy. The observed value for the final velocity of the nerdapult is 13.0i minus 6.60j centimeters per second. So I think we can say the physics works. The physics works,
The physics works. The physics works,
The physics works.
You know, that was almost exactly the same as when we did this without unit vectors.
Yeah, we used the conservation of momentum equation in the exact same way to solve for the final velocity of the nerdapult, and then just substituted in the unit vector version of the final velocity of the ball to get the unit vector version of the final velocity of the nerdapult.
Yeah, almost exactly the same.
Yep. Okay, I have a question. Why is it that when we take the ratios of the y and x velocity finals of the ball and the nerdapult, we get the same number? In other words, why are 179 over -351 and -6.59631 over 12.93467 both equal to the same number?
Because they are moving in opposite directions.
Sure. But why would that mean the ratios of their y and x final velocities equal the same number?
Because they are both moving at the same angle relative to the x direction, Therefore, the tangent of the angle, which describes both of their final velocities, which equals opposite over adjacent, equals the same thing.
Okay. Because both angles are the same, the tangent of both angles is the same, and the tangent of each angle equals the final velocity y value over the final velocity x value. That makes sense. Thanks.
You are welcome. Very nice, Bobby. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.